Hi guys, we are working with trig ratios and I'm going to work with one word. It's called contrast. What does contrast mean? It's when you take two opposites and you put them next to each other and you contrast them, or you show the differences. You can highlight and dramatize an idea. If you want to show how tall something is, you put something short next to it. So you get opposites and you put them together. Well, there's two opposites here called sine and cos. Well, they've got different type of angle systems, and what I'm going to do is show you how you can have these two guys and come up with the same answer on a ratio. So let's use this example here right next to me. We have a right angled triangle. There's our little right angle down there, our little friend. There he is. And we've got angles around this and we've got lengths. Now the lengths we have is 5 for the hypotenuse. Over here we have 3, and over here down the bottom on this length we have 4. Now, what the question asks is to find sine theta as a ratio. So if we're looking for sine theta, quite simply, what we do is we write down sine theta, which is this guy down here. So we're working with this angle. Sine theta equals, now what does sine theta equal again? It's opposite over what? Opposite over hypotenuse. Now, if we look at this and we want to find opposite, it's straight ahead, isn't it? Like that. So straight opposite the sine theta, pointing right across there, is the number 3. So let's write down first of all opposite over hypotenuse. So let's go back to that again. Opposite is 3, so let's write down 3. So that's 3 over, now over what? Hypotenuse, yeah? It says hypotenuse. So the hypotenuse here is 5. So sine theta, quite simply, is 3/5. Yeah? So there's our 3/5. Now, what we're looking for is cos 90 minus theta for the second part of this question. Let's look at that now. We're looking for cos bracket 90 minus theta. Now, if you've never come across this, I am going to show you how to understand the strategy involved here. Cos 90 minus theta clearly is not in our diagram, is it? You can't see it anywhere in the triangle. We have theta here. We have kind of an empty angle up here, so I'm going to work it out up here. Now, what is 90 minus theta exactly? Well, it works like this. You know how all angles add up to 180 degrees in a triangle? Well, if we have theta here, no matter what it may be, if we have theta here, and we've got 90 here, whatever's left clearly has to be 90 minus theta. Whatever that angle is, take away that. Whatever's left is going to give us that. So this angle here will be 90 minus theta. So let me just put that in. So I have 90 minus theta. Now that's the angle in there, because angle sum of triangle, as I explained. So if that's 90 minus theta, we are looking for cos 90 minus theta. I wonder what that's going to equal. So first of all, what does cos equal? Well, cos equals adjacent, isn't it? Whatever adjacent is to the angle. So if we're looking for cos of this angle, we got adjacent, which happens to be 3 again, doesn't it? So let's write down adjacent. Adjacent over what? Cos is adjacent over hypotenuse. Over hypotenuse, let's see what that equals. Adjacent for cos 90 minus theta, so that is a cos now. So going down, adjacent is to the left there. Right? So it's 3. So that equals 3 over hypotenuse over 5. So clearly what we have here is two contrasts, cos with sine, and both come up with exactly the same answer. Sine theta is 3/5, and cos 90 minus theta is also 3/5.
Take a minute to check out our website at http://www.vividmaths.com. You'll find additional resources, cheat sheets, transcripts, and other maths videos that are not available on YouTube. Lastly, don't forget to subscribe to get access to all the written answers for your maths questions, plus other special offers.